Have you ever noticed lots of duplicate keywords inside of your Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic catalog? I love Lightroom, but the truth is that Lightroom Classic's keywording system can easily become a complete mess if you accidentally mix flat and hierarchical keywords together. If your keywords have become a clutter jumble, then let's jump right in and let me show you how we can solve this problem. If the keywording feature had been more carefully designed, then the program should recognize that the term sunrise is already in play. And this program should prevent me from creating an exact duplicate for that specific word. But sadly, if I click on the little plus right here, and I type in that same word again, well, now I have redundant keywords. I have a sunrise here, and a sunrise right there. To see an example of the mess that this can create, watch what happens when I go to add this keyword to another image. See how the smart typing now suggests the hierarchical form. But if I don't accept that, then I get the flat form. That difference is confusing, and over time, this redundancy can become an enormous mess. Now, in a perfect world, Lightroom would have some sort of merge duplicate keywords together command. But tragically, that kind of intelligence does not currently exist in this software. So now that you've seen how this problem can get created, let's talk about how to clean things up. First, if you accidentally get hierarchical keywords whenever you create any new keyword, then we need to nip that problem in the bud. To figure that out, we need to figure out which keyword is the root at the top of the food chain. For this demo, I've set this up with the time of day container. So you may have to find your own, but when you find that root level keyword, then right click on it and make sure that this put new keywords inside command is not accidentally turned on. Next, if you have a keyword hierarchy that you no longer want, then you can drag and drop things around to clean things up as long as there are no duplicates. I'll use the word night here as an example. To remove night from the time of day hierarchy, I can drag this one up and drop since there's currently no duplicate for that word within my flat list. When you're dragging keywords around, though, pay careful attention to where the blue line goes. Accidentally placing that blue line on top of another keyword will not make things any better, since it just moves that keyword from one hierarchy into another. To keep the list flat, I need to be careful where I position this tiny little blue line. If I try the drag and drop method with the word sunrise, then nothing is going to happen. This word will not become flat because an exact duplicate already appears in my list and Lightroom won't automatically merge the two together. So to solve this problem, we need to follow 5 steps. Step 1 is easy. To find every instance of the flat keyword and its hierarchical duplicates, I can type in this keyword list filter box right here. In this case, I'll type in sunrise. And then Classic will show me this keyword only, and it will temporarily hide all of the others away. Step 2. Next, I need to find all of the images in this catalog where the hierarchical form of this word is in use. To do that, I'm going to tap on this tiny little arrow that appears just to the right of the keyword that I want to remove. Clicking this tiny little arrow tells the program to activate the metadata filter and to find all of the images that have this exact term. Step 3. Once I've found all of these images, then I can use the Edit Select All command to make them all active. Step 4. Now, I can come over to the keywords list panel, and then I can drag the flat form of this keyword out onto my thumbnail grid. Dragging a keyword onto the grid automatically applies it to all of your selected images. This step is important. Be sure that you drag the keyword that you want to keep before you move on to the final step. In fact, up here now, you can actually see the flat sunrise and the hierarchical in that big keywords box. Step 5. To get rid of the hierarchical version, I can right-click on that keyword, and then I can choose the delete option. That's it. Now the hierarchical keyword has been removed from this catalog, but the flat keyword has been assigned to all the relevant images. As long as I follow each step in order, then I've not reduced my ability to search for these images using this keyword at some future date. Well, there you go.
I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.